Right, so let's start it. Before that, okay, let me remove the HTTP. This is not required because by default HTTP will be concatenated by JMeter. You just need to write maps dot from here itself. Okay, maps.googleapis.com. So it's enough if you start from it here, not required HTTPS extensions and all. And I'll go back to my view results tree and start running it. It should run for 25 users, right? Let me click. Yeah, you can see that. That's it. We have done. And see how body size in bytes, response data, request to this API. Okay, there is something wrong here. If you see it here, it says error message, request denied. Request to this API must be over SSL. Maybe the key what I have provided is expired here, so that's the reason I'm getting some weird error here. Or I think request to API over SSL. Okay, it should be secure. Right, let's give HTTPS here. I think this should work because it's asking the request should be transferred over secured layer, right? So HTTPS will serve that secure layer for us. And let's try it again. Let me delete all these. Yeah, okay, fine. So we got response data, right? So remember, we can achieve the same thing with SOAP UI tool. Okay, so there we have done all these and finally we got the response. So same style of REST API testing you can also achieve with JMeter too. Fine, so same thing, you have this kind of UI to enter parameters in SOAP UI as well, path, server name, and ultimately you will see the response in the right side of the pane in SOAP UI tool. So same thing you can achieve in JMeter also. But the other feature what you have here is you can also load test it. Of course, you can do load testing with SOAP UI tool also, but I'm just saying both SOAP UI and JMeter will work well for REST API testing. Okay, so this is how you can test your REST API using JMeter tool, right? So if you are in my SOAP UI course, if you have enrolled in my SOAP UI course, you know how to execute this REST APIs and SOAP UI test cases from that tool. Okay, so this is a handy, even with, you can achieve this with the help of JMeter. If someone are at your work, if they ask you to work on JMeter for running this REST test cases, you can use this. But if you want to automate them, SOAP UI is the perfect, right? So manually you can do this in JMeter, but if you want to automate these test cases, passing the values dynamically and scheduling the Maven runs, Jenkins, if you want to develop a framework, then SOAP UI tool is the only solution for it. Even you can do with JMeter, but that's a very hard one. Okay, you can do it smoothly with that tool. If it is a manual perspective, then this looks good for you. And if you see here, right, place ID, this all the response you got, JSON response, when you send the data, and it says body size in bytes 4180. Okay, so you can now get the parameters. So how much time it has taken, load time. See, first load time is 613, but at the 25th request, load time is 572. It's coming down. Okay, so it's clear idea for it, right? See how the load time is getting down. And 1 minute, let me go up, 613, and this is really 458, and good. See, six load time decreasing means it's a good for us. If load time increases, then there is a problem with our REST API. For example, if load time is 600 and if it is a 10,000 or 1,000 at the last request, that means there is something fishy with your API. It's not able to handle even 25 requests also. But here that is the not case. Load time is fluctuating. It is 600 at the starting, but at the end it is 400. That means it's good. However, this is expected because Google have the big servers and you are just putting the load of 25 users. Go and put 5000 users and see. Then you might see the load changes, right? But I don't want to do it now because definitely Google have some mechanism and will stop us after some 1000 requests, saying might be it is a robot. Okay, until unless you have valid permissions, you cannot do that, right? So this is how you can actually test your REST API in JMeter as well as putting load on it, right? If you want other parameters as well, you have a proper listeners here and you can see what is the aggregate report and run it again. Okay, you can see the total samples, 24 samples, 25, okay, the execution done. Average time it's taking 972 seconds and 90% times it was at 1378, and throughput, this is the important parameter. So each request took 5.2 seconds. Okay, so in this way you can, there are many listeners in this, it's up to you, go and explore and see what you want, right? So that's based upon the parameters what you have given from your client or from your work. Okay, they have some people might be asking only throughput, some people might be asking what's the load time it's taking. Based upon the parameters given by your client, that parameters you need to set it in this listeners, add thread group, right click, add listener. Based upon that parameters, see what reports, what listeners will fit your parameters and import that and verify the reports. Okay, so that's how we can put and load on REST API. So it's similar and straightforward. If you want to see some other requests, just I'll just as assignment try this. Okay, so this is a server and this is my path. These are output parameters, and output parameters you have it here. Just try it out and see the output how you are getting. Okay, so my assignment here is, if you are already enrolled in my SOAP UI course, complete this REST API test case, test it in both SOAP UI as well as JMeter. Okay, so do it in multiple tools, it will get a lot of confidence to you. Okay, if you are not having in the SOAP UI tool course access, then you just come do this assignment in JMeter. So as first request, I have explained in my lecture, right? So it's your turn to do the second text search request. So if you're able to do this, then you will be getting a proper confidence. And if you're facing any difficulties, please drop me a message in our discussion so that I'll address there. And this is the link where you can hit and check it, but make sure you generate your own key. For that, watch my previous lectures. Fine. So that's it about REST API testing in JMeter as well as putting load on it. Thank you.